Hello people, welcome back to BIT Media, Science and Technology.
We all exactly know what pancreas are, right? Did you ever hear about artificial pancreas? Wondering what it is? Let's know about this artificial pancreas in today's video. If you're not sure exactly what your pancreas does, relax. You're not alone. It is an organ deep inside your belly, which plays an important role in keeping your blood sugar level under control. On September 26th of 2016, the US Food and Drug Administration approved the first automated insulin delivery system, so-called artificial pancreas, for the people with type 1 diabetes. Insulin is a hormone necessary for initiating the release of sugar into the cells in the body and brain to provide fuel to the cells. People with type 1 diabetes must replace the insulin that their bodies no longer produce through multiple daily injections through a tiny catheter attached to an insulin pump. The device does this via a small catheter inserted beneath the skin and attached to a tube that's attached to an insulin pump. This insulin delivery site needs to be changed approximately every 3 days. Artificial pancreas act a lot like your real pancreas, constantly checking your blood sugar level and releasing insulin when your blood sugar gets too high. It also releases a small trickling of insulin continuously. This advanced technology is now officially being referred to as automated insulin delivery system, and they are getting very close to truly changing the game. When the blood sugar is too high, pump automatically delivers carefully measured doses of insulin into body through a patch and a thin tube. As the blood sugar returns to your target level, the insulin dose stops. The device is adjusted as needed. A smartphone app lets you and your doctor keep track of your blood sugar levels and insulin doses. Dr. Jeffrey Shuren, Director of FDA Center for Devices and Radiological Health, said that this kind of technology can provide people with type 1 diabetes greater freedom to live their lives without having to constantly and manually monitor baseline glucose levels and administer insulin. In general, the devices have done much to increase the user's time in their target range and help them maintain control of their glucose levels, especially post-meal and overnight. Isn't it amazing? Well, that's all for today. Let's meet again with another interesting device. Till then, take care, stay safe, and don't forget to like, share, and comment, and subscribe to BIT. Bye-bye.